डियर स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे आई एम टेकिंग द टॉपिक फ्रॉम योर एक्सरसाइज नोटबुक। एक्सरसाइज बुक दैट इज सर्कल ग्राफ और पाई चार्ट। Here we represent the data in graphical form, and that is a special type of graph which is circle graph. In circle we show the data. How to represent this we will study. These all in this section. Here we see a graph, the time spent by a child during a day. It is first graph, sleep 8 hours, school 6 hours, play 3 hours, others 3 hours, homework 4 hours. And there is another graph, age group of people in a town. 50,000, 50 to 60 years, 30,000, 0 to 14 years, and 20,000, 60 years and above. We see these two graphs. These two graphs are called circle graphs. It is another named by pie chart. A circle graph shows the relationship between a whole and its part. Whole and its part. Here the whole circle is divided into sectors. Above you see circle is divided into different parts, and these are called sectors. The size of each sector is proportional to the activity or information it represents. A smaller sector shows the smaller quantity or data, and larger part of sector shows the large quantity of data. We see it is proportional to the activity or information. Just we can find the fraction for each sector. Suppose we have to find the proportion or ratio for sleepiness. Here, number of sleeping hours are 8 hours, and whole day hours are 24 hours. So we make a 8 hours upon 24 hours. It is 1/3 part of the whole circle. So this sector is drawn 1/3 part of circle. Similarly, other sectors, the time spent in school 6 hours, and part will be number of school hours upon whole day hours, 6 hours upon 24 hours. That is, after cancel out we get 1/4 part. It means 1/4 part of circle represents the school hours. Similarly, we can calculate the part of other sectors. These graphs and this representation is called circle graph or pie chart. Here There are some questions for try these. First, each of the following pie chart, figure 5.5, gives you a different piece of information about your class. Find the fraction of the circle representing each of these information. We have to find the fraction. Here in first figure, there are 50% girls and 50% boys. You have to write girls 50/100. That will give you 1/2. So fraction for girls will be 1/2. And for boys, 50/100, that means 1/2 again. So the boys fraction will also 1/2. In second graph, transport to school. Here the graph shows the transport to school. Walk 40%. It means walk is equal to 40/100. That is, after cancelling out, you get 2/5. Cycling 20%. That means 20/100, and it will give you 1/5 again. And bus or car 40%. Bus or car fraction will be 40/100. That is 2/5 again. Similarly, in third figure, love and hate mathematics. Mathematics lovers are some and haters are some. Here haters are 15%. So lovers will be 85%, because whole circle will be just like 100. 15% haters will be equal to 15/100. That is equal to, after cancel out, you get 3/20. And remaining 85/100. Lovers, mathematics lovers, 85/100. So it will give you 17/20. Now there is second question. Answer the following question based on pie chart that gives figure 5.6. Which type of program are viewed the most? The largest sector will show the most. Here largest sector is entertainment, that is 50%. So the program most viewed by viewers of channel on TV is equal to entertainment. So entertainment portion is mostly viewed. Second, which two type of program have number of viewers equal to those watching sports channel? Here sports channel is 25%. Now you see here 15% is news viewers and informative viewers are 10%. So news viewers and informative viewers, there is equal to 15% plus 10%, that is 25%. So, and you see here sports viewers are also 25%. So sports viewers is equal to news viewers plus informative viewers. Now how to draw the pie chart. Above you see how to calculate from chart the numbers or the fraction. In this section we see how to draw a pie chart. Here the favorite flavors of ice cream for student of school is given in percentage or as follows. Flavors, chocolate, percentage of children preferring 50%, vanilla 25%, other flavors 25%. Let us represent this data in a pie chart. So you see the pie chart is a circular chart. In a circle there is a complete angle at the center. So complete angle at the center is equal to 360 degree. We draw a radius to we draw a circle and then draw a radius horizontal and then see that whole complete angle at the center is equal to 360 degree. Now you have to find the central angle of each sector, each part. Here you have to find first the fraction of each part. Here flavors chocolate, students preferring 50%. So in fraction this will equal to 50/100, that is 1/2. So angle will be fraction of 360, that means half or 1/2 of 360, it is equal to 180 degree. Here vanilla flavor is equal to 25% in fraction, that is 25/100 is equal to 1/4. So fraction angle will be 1/4 of 360, 90 degree. Other flavors are 25%, so in fraction, that is 25/100, that will give you 1/4. So fraction of 360 will be equal to 1/4 of 360, that is again 90 degree. Now the steps, what will you do? You draw a circle with a some radius, just like 5 cm, and mark center O and draw a radius OA. Then you have to draw these angles 1/1. The angle of the sector of chocolate is 180, so you draw 180 degree on radius OA, that is 180 degree. So angle AOB is equal to 180 degree. In third step you have to make another angle at vanilla. It is previous angle is completed AOB, so you take OB from O, OB line, and from O draw an angle of 90 degree for vanilla. So in radius OB, taking point O and draw angle of 90 degree, it will give you vanilla angle. And then again you draw, suppose this line is OC, so in OC line taking point O we draw again 90 degree for other flavors. Thus you see that whole circle is divided into three parts: chocolate 180 degree, vanilla 90 degree, and other flavors 90 degree. This is the process to draw a pie chart. Now there is example adjoining pie chart gives the expenditure. on various items and savings of family during the month. Here a pie chart is given in which every portion of expenditure is given. House rent 10%, education for children 15%, for food 25%, clothes 10%, savings 15%, others 20%, transport 5%. Thus we have the expenditure in different form in the percentage form. So question is, on which item the expenditure was maximum? You see the graph and you may see the percentage also. Here you see in food 25% is the maximum value. So you will write the expenditure on food is maximum. Second, expenditure of which item is equal to the total savings of the family. Here the saving is 15% and education of children is also 15%. It means in saving and expenditure on education for children are same. In third part, if the monthly saving of the family is 3000, what is the monthly expenditure on clothes? Here you will see in clothes the fraction will be there is expenditure 10%, so it will give you 10/100, that is 1/10. So it means, or you can also see that it is 15%, that means it is the 15% of total expenditure. So you can write the expenditure on clothes is equal to 15% of 3000, that will give you it is the monthly saving of family is 3000. What is the monthly expenditure on cloth? So saving is 15%. It means 15% of sum, meaning total. 15% of X is equal to 3000. You may write here 15% of X is equal to 3000. So X is equal to 3000 into 15/100. Or other method is also here. 50% represents 3000 and here clothes are 10%, so 10% will represent by this 3000/15×10, that is 2000. This is also method. There may be another method you can use, but here this method is given, that is 15% represent 3000, so 1 will represent 33000/15, so 10 will represent 3000/15×10, thus we get 2000. Here in example 2 we are given data and you have to draw a chart for this data. Just see, on a particular day the sales of different items of bakers shops are given below. Ordinary bread 320, fruit bread 80, cakes and plastics pasties 160, biscuits 120, others 40, and thus total is 720. So many rupees are for different items. You have to draw graph. So for making graph, first we write items and their sales, and sales total, that is 720. So item is ordinary bread 320. Now you have to find fraction. The 320 upon total is 720. So 320 upon 720, that is 4/9. So its angle at the center will be 4/9 of 360, because total angle is 360, so it will give you 180 degree. Now biscuits sale in rupees is 120, so fraction 120 upon 720, that is equal to 1/6 also. So central angle is 1/6 of 360, that is again 60 degree. Cake and pastry is 160, so fraction will be 160 upon 720, that is 2/9. So angle will be 2/9 into 360, that is 80 degree. Now fruit bread is equal to 80, so fraction 80 upon 720 is equal to 1/9, so that is equal to angle is equal to 1/9 into 360, that is 40 degree. And other, the sale in rupees is 40, so in fraction 40 upon 720, that is give you 1/18, so central angle will be 1/18 of 360, that is equal to 20 degree. So we have different angles: 160 degree, 60 degree, 80 degree, 40 degree, and 20 degree. We make these angles in a circle. First we draw a circle of some radius and draw a radius OA, then make angle 160 degree to it. Where it ends, draw that line, and at that line we again draw the angle of 60 degree, and that line, that again a line is obtained, and at that line we again make angle of 80 degree. So at this angular line is again another angular line is obtained. On this line we will make angle of 40 degree, and rest 20 degrees also with previous line to first angular line. Thus we can make its graph like this and shade in different way and write their names at the side of each sector. Thus we will draw a pie chart. Now you have some questions, try these and exercise. So following above information you can solve easily. Okay, thank you. Have a good day.